Okay, I will start the class. And I talk to you the general, that's right, the design of the bubble cap, the valve, and the tray. That's right, we have valve tray like this, and see if it look like the filtration, that we have the hole, something like this, and also the bubble cap. This is the general tree design of the plate. We use the dissolved plate to increase the contact between the liquid and vapor, and then also to increase the separation. Then we back to the general for that case. Except for translate from ideal plate to the actual plate, we have to correction between the efficiency of the plate. We have to correct for the efficiency of the plate. There are another important decision. Some at least important fixing the number of plates. That's right. We have to made before the design is complete. The type of tray, as I show you, that's why we have the hole, that's why the pattern of the hole of the tray, the downcomer of the side, that's why downcomer side. That's why we have the flow of the vapor upward and also flow of liquid downward. That's why the bubble cap, the valve tray, that's the hole for vapor upward only. How about the liquid flow? The liquid flow downward, we have to decide the downcomer, the area for liquid flow upward. And the liquid will flow downward by overflow, something like this, which is giving you the design. And also the via high mean the design for the overflow of liquid. That's right. Allowable vapor rate, that's right, vapor rate. Pressure drop per tray and column diameter, this is the important parameter to decide the tray column. Like the size of tray, the type of the tray, the spacing and the size of the dark common, right? The height of the wheel for the overflow of liquid, vapor, pressure drop, diameter of, right? Diameter of pressure. Okay. The most design for the deterioration column, mostly we found in petroleum industry. That's like we would like to deteriorate the crude oil. Is it the last company that we use to design the column to deteriorate, to separate the crude oil to gas, benzene, gasoline, diesel, naphtha, something like this. Okay. The tower diameter for the petroleum industry mode is about 1 feet, that's right. From 1 feet to 30 feet, that's right, for 300 millimeter to 9 meter. So the diameter is quite large for that scale. And the number of plates from a few to about 100 is maybe from 1 to 100 number of the plates. The plate spacing vary from 150 millimeter or less to 1 or 2 meters. This is the spacing between the plates. That's like something we have plate 1, plate 2, plate 3. The deep spacing between the plates is vary from 150 millimeters. That's not less than 1 or 2 meters. This is for the general design. Okay. The column may operate at high pressure or low, from temperature of liquid gas up to 900 degrees Celsius. That's 900 degrees Celsius. This is in the electrifying sodium and potassium vapor. This is an example. If we electrifying or deteriorate the sodium and potassium vapor is made used at high temperature, higher to 900 degrees Celsius. 900 degrees Celsius. The normal operation for the sieve plate, we design the sieve plate to bring a rising stream of vapor. But I talked to you already, we design the sieve plate to bring the flow of vapor upward to intimate contact with the descending stream of liquid, the liquid flow downward, the vapor flow upward, and then we have to contact between liquid and vapor. The liquid flow across the plate, and liquid will flow downward by flow over a wheel or up, overflow the wheel by downcomer, that's right, downcomer. And then fall to the bottom or the below pit. That's right, the below pit. The column as a whole is therefore cross fall because the liquid fall upward. Bubble fall upward. And liquid fall downward, but fall downward by cross fall in the plate, right, in the plate, and then fall over the weir downward to the neck pit and the bottom. That's right, the bottom. This is the picture to show you the four characteristics of the liquid and vapor. Liquid and vapor. You have the, they show that the vapor is fall upward, and liquid fall downward, but liquid fall downward by overflow. For example, we have the weir. That's right. If the level of liquid is higher than this, if you fall downward, and also fall downward. It's a dark comer. That's right. Liquid. Cross flow, liquid, and vapor flow upward, vapor flow upward. And then this is the four characteristics, because upward of vapor and downward of the liquid with flow across, that's right, cross flow in this direction, cross flow in this direction, and through the mixing or contact between liquid and vapor, that's right, liquid and vapor. And then we can just increase the separation efficiency, that's right, separation efficiency. And also, this is the design as a dark comer. It's the liquid vapor. It will be the overflow of liquid downward. Like okay, this dark comer. This is the dark comer. That's right. It's shown that the liquid flow downward is dark comer. This dark comer. Usually occupy 10 to 15% of the column cross-sectional area, leaving 70 to 80% of the column area for bubble and contacting. What does it mean? This area, about 10 to 15%, right? 10 to 15% is it there? And another 70 to 80% is the area for contact between liquid and vapor. In the column, we have for this 100% of the area in the column. 10 to 15 is the dark comer for flow downward of liquid. 70 to 80% is the, for the area for contact between vapor and liquid. In the tray, that's right, the cross flow of liquid, the vapor flow upward like this. In small column, the dark comer may be applied well to the plate and project up above the plate. From the circular wheel, right? For a very large column, we have an additional dark comer may be provided at the middle of the plate to decrease the length of liquid flow path. What does it mean? If your diameter is very large, generally we have the dark comer at the side by side, but sometimes for the large column, we can add at the middle, the side, the dark comer for liquid flow down at the dark comer. Because if we beside the large diameter, that means the cross flow is very long. Very long. Okay, for that case, you can add dark comer at the middle, as I thought for the last part. The hole, usually the hole for the side, usually 5 to 12 millimeter inside and arranged in triangular pattern. The hole of the place, one or two row of the hole may be omit near the overflow weir, right? And some hole may be omit near the liquid inlet and keep vapor bubble out of the comer. This is the hole of the okay. Okay, under the normal condition, the vapor velocity is high enough to create a 40 mixture of liquid and vapor. That's right. If the, generally we have two vapor is high enough to That's right. The vapor should be flow high enough to circulate the liquid and vapor mixture. That's right. You have to flow to circulate. If the high flow of vapor will be the circulation in the liquid bed, and also increase the contacting between liquid and vapor. That's right. This is the design. And the pressure drop across the plate for each plate, it usually 50 to 100 millimeter water, millimeter water, the pressure drop over 40 pairs column. It's maybe 2 or 4 mass water. This is the pressure drop. Okay, the design, the pressure drop is usually given by equivalent heat in millimeter or in liquid. That should be the equivalent high, not heat, sorry, this is the equivalent high. ST equal to SD plus SL. ST, total pressure drop per pair. For this case, we calculate per pair. But in reality, we have more than one pair, and then you can sum up. Okay, ST is the total pressure per pair. Pressure in millimeters of liquid. And SD is friction loss for die pair. Okay, for this case, if we assume there is no liquid and vapor in the system, this is the friction loss of die pair. SL is the equivalent heat of liquid on the pair. This is the total pressure drop. Okay, how to calculate SD? You can estimate or approximate SD by this equation. By this equation. This equation. That's right. For this equation, you know, like U zero is the vapor velocity through the hole. Low V, low L, density of vapor and liquid. C zero means the orific coefficient, because for this case, we have the hole. We can approximate like the orific, like the hole. It's the coefficient of the orific. Okay. The coefficient, that's right, can be calculated by this. It approximately is 51. And also, if U is expressed in feet per second, SD, SD in would be checked to this. This SD, aside from this equation, you can use the coefficient based on the unit by this equation. If the coefficient for the plate is maybe very, as I model C plate, it thickness 0.1 to 0.3 times the whole sign. For this thickness and the typical open area is 0.08 to 0.1. This is the general, the C0. It approximates 0.66 to 0.72. That's right. For this case, the approximate value of C0. We can do this. Okay, this figure shows you the correlation or the relationship between C0, discharge coefficient, and area of the hole. This is the whole area divided by the column area. If you know like the diameter of the column, like this, and also we have the hole in this, now you have lots of hole, that's not a lot of hole. This is the area of the hole divided by the cross-sectional area of the column. That's right. This is the area of hole in the cross-sectional area of the column. And this is the discharge, C0. And this is the tray thickness divided by the hole diameter. And that tray thickness divided by the hole diameter. You can see the relationship between these three parameters by this equation. You can use this to decide for that case. For example, if the whole area of the whole column is 0.1, that's right. 0.1, and then the design for the tray thickness per whole diameter like this, you get about 1.2. And then you can calculate the C0 by this curve, And then you can calculate SD, that's right, you can calculate SD from this equation. Okay, how about the SL? Previously, we calculated the total pressure drop equal to SD plus SL. SD, you can calculate by the this equation. How about SL? You can calculate SL equal to beta SW plus SOW. SW is the wear high, the high of the overflow for the column. It's the wear high. This is the V high, that's right, the high of the V. If the liquid is higher than this, liquid when we fall downward to the down common, that's right, this is the V. and SOW. SOW is the high of the clear liquid over the VIA high. We have the VIA high and also the liquid that flow over the VIA high, the high over the VIA. Or mean over, that's right. For example, if the liquid like this, it's the SOW, that's right, SOW. This is the SOW. And also the correlation beta factor, you can calculate SL. For some calculation, that's why for the high over the VIA is calculated from the Fancy equation, the strength, you know, we can use this from the Fancy equation. From the SOW equal to this equation. And QL is the flow rate of clear liquid. LW is the length of the VIA. That's like the length of the VIA. If Q over LW is gallon per minute per inch, coefficient is 0.48. That's right. If you use this unit, you can use this instead of this. That's right. You can use instead of this. This is the VIA high, LW. That's right. This is the column, cross-sectional area, the column. This is the for downcomer. It's also for downcomer. So we have two sides. Flow from the top and flow to the bottom. That's right, flow to the top for the below column. We have to the two hole for the scale. If you look at the horizontal and vertical section, this is, that's right. We have two sides of the dark common. This is the three, that's right, the dark common area. This is the cross-sectional area, and this is the downcomer. The downcomer from the top, the downcomer for downward. And also, this is the length of the VIA. The length of the VIA. For typical VIA height of 25 to 50, and the thermal rank vapor velocity, the beta value are 0.4 to 0.7. You can use the beta value is between 0.4 and 0.7. For design purpose, usually we use beta equal to 0.6. And we can use the beta equals 0.6 for that case, for the general design. Okay. The next equation that we use to total high of the clear. Total high of the clear, that means if you back to the downcomer, set it in the downcomer. Behind the downcomer, like this. It's the reset, it's the liquid level in the downcomer. That's a liquid level in the downcomer. This is the high offset C. It's like HFLSD part 2B, something like this. It's the high offset, clear liquid. That's liquid with no bubble. If we know that in the liquid flow, and also we have some vapor in the liquid. Okay, this is the most, we have some bubble, and assume such is the liquid with no bubble of gas, only liquid. That means, such means the level or the high of the liquid, that clear liquid with no bubble of the gas. This is such. You can calculate such C. It's SW high of VIA, high of the liquid over the VIA. Total pressure drop, SFL. That's right, SFL. And also you can calculate such C. You know this already. That's right. The actual level of the liquid set in the downcomer is greater than such C. That means the level of liquid. That means the level of liquid with no bubble, that's right, with no bubble. Okay, and then you can calculate the fraction of liquid and liquid with no bubble. We call this psi d, that equal to psi d over psi. More generally, we use the psi equal to 0.5 about 50-50. Perhaps so we have the, this is the, is the liquid in the outcome. That's right. And sometimes we have the, it's a bubble. This okay for this generally we assume a set and set C is a half of set. In generally we can assume that it's 50% has been allowed this because at the top it flow from the mixture of liquid and bubble of gas. Okay, there are some gas in the tops and also bottom mostly is liquid. That's right. Set C mean the high of the clear liquid with no bubble or with no gas. Okay. In general, we assume a half of set. Set is the total high of liquid. Set C of liquid only, no bubble. But we assume set C is a half of set. Okay. In some comment, there's a limit for the seed tray. Or at low vapor velocity, the pressure drop is not great enough to prevent the liquid flow that I draw. Okay, some for this problem, we have the hole of the tray. We design the hole to flow upward of the vapor. But if the system with the very low velocity of the vapor, what does it mean? That means there are some liquid flow downward in the hole. Or downward, you know, this is the problem. This condition is called the whipping and is more likely to occur if there is strength gradient in liquid and afford the plate aside. And the upper limit of the vapor velocity in a seed tray column, we can calculate by the velocity at which the entrainment become excessive. And also this called the lag drop in the plate efficiency, aside, plate efficiency. Okay, this is a limit called the flooding point or more probably the entrainment fluid point. Okay, the flooding point mean all the liquid, that's a liquid flow downward in the hole also. The vapor is low velocity, that's a small amount of the vapor, that means all of the tray, a lot of water, a lot of the liquid, that's a lot of the liquid in the system. We call it the flooding process or flooding condition. That's right. Lots of liquid, that means flood. Okay, what is, there is no contact between liquid and vapor because in the tray is only or most of liquid. No separation, that's right. No separation. Okay, for this case, you have to increase the flow of vapor, that's right, and decrease the liquid flow to improve our efficiency for that case. This is the flooding condition. The flooding condition is the limiting tension for the operating. You have to cancel the flooding. That's right, you have to cancel the flooding. And also in the absorption, I will talk to you later, and also the flooding. Okay. And also for the case, you would like to cancel the flooding. You have to determine what is the maximum or minimum velocity of gas or vapor fit. So this equation show you the maximum possible vapor velocity used in the deterioration column. That's right, used in the deterioration column. You see how to KV. That's a low L is density of liquid, low V density of vapor. Sigma is the surface tension of liquid, And KV you can calculate from this curve. That's right. From this curve, KV is the correlation constant for flooding. Okay, this is, if you know the term L, V, low, you know UC, and then you can calculate the phase spacing, or if you know the phase spacing, you can calculate the UC. That's right. Okay, if you know this term, X exit, you know the phase spacing. Phase spacing means the space between the top and bottom pit. That's right, the top and bottom, above and below pit, the spacing. If you know the spacing, you can calculate UC. So because the UC, it also depends on the spacing between the plate. It's the maximum possible vapor If you know this, you can operate by this. You can operate by. And then you can cancel or protect the flooding. That's how you can protect the flooding. Okay. For this, I will talk to you later to calculate about the seed tray design. Or Wednesday, I will talk to this example to how to calculate this. You have to calculate it for the next lecture by Wednesday. These are the wild tree. That's right. Here is the home. That's why we talk about the home. But this case is the wild tree. This is the wild. And we have the flow of vapor. And then we have the home. That's right. In the side by side. The vapor flow. This is also the technique to protect the flow downward of the liquid in the home. That's right. Is it the improving design to protect the downward of the liquid? If you directly only the hole, if the low vapor velocity, sometimes the liquid will flow downward and also make the flooding. Is it the flooding? Okay, to protect the flooding, we can improve the design by using the wild tray or bubble cap. You increase the efficiency, will cancel or will protect the flooding for that case. Okay. The next step, we talk to calculate the efficiency. From previous, we talk about to calculate the number of the column, or sorry, number of the plates. And also, this is the ideal. It's the theoretical technique. For this case, we talk about the real system. We have to use the plate efficiency to convert from the ideal to the real. Okay, we have to kind of the plate. Is efficiency, right? The overall efficiency. For this case, we concern for the entire column. And the second one, we call it morphia efficiency. This we talk about the page by page, only one or single page. And the last one, local efficiency, which pertain to a specific location. That's right. Okay, we have three, the overall. The second one is page by page or a single page by morphia. And local efficiency. That's right. Local, we check the single page also, but location on the specific location. For the overall, we simplify by eta zero. That's right. Eta zero is a simple to use, but it's least fundamental. The overall efficiency is defined at the ratio of the number of ideal pairs divided by the number of actual pairs. This is the overall efficiency. You know the ideal pairs from the technique that I talked to you. You know the inlet condition. You know the outlet condition at the bottom and the top. You contract the Metcalfe curve and then you draw the triangle to determine the number of pairs. Right? That is the ideal pair. Okay, you know ideal pair. And you know the real pair, you can calculate efficiency. Or you decide, you would like to get the efficiency high enough, you know the ideal pair. You can calculate actual pair. And calculate actual pair. For example, if we have six ideal pairs, we have six ideal pairs, and also the overall efficiency is 60%. And then you can calculate number of actual pairs. That's right. Number of actual pairs equal to number of pairs ideal divided by the efficiency is 60% or 0.6. You get 10 actual pairs. That's right. 10 actual pairs. In generally, the number of actual pairs should be higher. That's right. Or greater than ideal pairs. Greater than ideal pairs. The next, that's right. The Morphy efficiency. The Morphy efficiency, we consider single step. Conservation step. We talk about the compression at the top or bottom. We call the vapor flow upward, sorry, the bottom and the top flow upward from end plate to end plus one plate. For this case, we talk about Y n is the actual concentration of vapor leaving plate n. Y n plus one entering plate n. Y n star is the vapor in equilibrium. That's right, in equilibrium. Leaving the downpipe from place. For this case, we use the Morphy to determine for to the describe the composition from one plate to the next plate. That's right, one plate to the next plate. And the last one, we call it local efficiency, N prime. N prime is it's the same like the Morphy, but we talk about the concentration of vapor leaving specific location on plate N. And the same location, that's right, N plus one. Entering, that's right, leaving and entering in the same place. And also YEN, concentration in equilibrium. But instead we talk about equilibrium. That's right, talk about equilibrium. For this case, the YN prime cannot be greater than YEN, right? At equilibrium. That's right, at equilibrium. And the vapor concentration leaving the location N cannot be greater than at equilibrium. That's right. It's not greater than 100%. For the relationship between Morphy and local, for Morphy and local for small column, and the liquid or the mixture, that's right, the liquid and mixture flow to the form, so there is no measurement concentration. There is no concentration gradient. That means a well mix. If there is no concentration gradient, okay, you can approximately YN equal to YN prime for that case. Okay, for the small column, we can approximate local efficiency equal to Morphy efficiency at the small column. In the large column, sometimes the mixing is not good. There are some the concentration gradient. That means the local efficiency is lower than Morphy efficiency. It's maybe about 0.6, lower than the Morphy efficiency. Is for the Morphy efficiency and local efficiency. And also the relationship between Morphy and local efficiency is depend on the degree of mixing. I talk to you. For small column, these two efficiency is equal, but for large column, Morphy is greater than efficiency. That's the efficiency. This equation, that's why we talk about the Morphy and local efficiency, the relationship or the equation to talk about the Morphy and local efficiency. We use the term of parameter like Peclet number, the length of the liquid, the diffusivity based on the mixing, that's right, the diffusivity, the mixing, and the resident time of liquid in the plate. Resident time means the time that liquid stay in the plate, that's right, stay in the plate, until it flow downward. That's right, from the top plate flow to the plate and then flow downward. This is the time at the start to the plate and the last before to downward. We call the resident time. And then you can calculate the relationship between Morphy and local efficiency by the Peclet number. For this case, you use the Morphy efficiency. That's right, the Morphy efficiency. For this case, from the real system, that's right. From previously, we talked about the McCabe technique, you know, XD, this point equal to YD, and you know the feed point, you know the bottom. This is for ideal system. That's right. This is ideal system. Okay, for the real system, you can modify. And you can multiply by this equation. YE prime equal to Y plus eta M, YE minus Y. Is it for the real system? That's right, real system. You can modify by the eta M. That's right. This is for the ideal that you calculate previously. And this is for the ideal. That's right, this is for the ideal. Okay, for this case, we use the Morphy efficiency on XY diagram. That's right, on XY diagram. For this case, we use 0.6. That's right, 0.6. Okay, we get this line. And then you can calculate the number of pairs, ideal pairs. This is the number of ideal pairs based on this operating line. And then you can calculate the number of real pairs from the dashed line. This is, you can calculate by this line, by contract the triangle, 1, 2, something like this. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, something like this for the real system. But for ideal system, you have to follow like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this. It's the same technique, but for the ideal system, you calculate based on I talked to you previously. That's right. For actual system, you have to modify by the efficiency, modify by the efficiency, by this equation. By this equation, y e minus y, y e prime minus y, like this. You get, or you calculate the, like this, b a and c a. B a mean the real right and the ideal right, and c a equal to y z divided by x z. That's right. Y z divided by x z, like this. Y z x z, okay. Based on the ratio, that's right, Morphy efficiency, the Morphy efficiency. Morphy efficiency equal to 0.6, approximately equal to BA divided by CA, that's right. BA divided by CA. BA from the real to the ideal. CA, C is the equilibrium. You can approximate this. Okay. If you know the ideal from previously, if you know the Morphy efficiency, you can contract the real line. That's right. And then you can count the number of pairs for that case. Count the number of pairs for that case. This for different equilibrium line. That's right. The different equilibrium line and also different in the number of the pairs. And for A, for this case, Morphy efficiency is greater than overall. This is the Morphy efficiency is less than overall. For this case, the overall is greater than Morphy efficiency. It also depends on the equilibrium line. Right? Depend on the equilibrium line. For the special case, that's like where the equilibrium line and operating line are straight, we can use this equation to calculate the overall. Calculate the overall. You know Morphy efficiency, MV. MV means the slope of the equilibrium line. Slope of the equilibrium line. M is slope of the equilibrium line. V is the amount of vapor and liquid phase L. That's right. You can calculate the overall efficiency by this equation. By this equation, if the operating line and equilibrium line is the string line for that case, you can use this equation. Okay, you talk to this example for Wednesday how to calculate by this case. And the last topic that we talked today, the factor that affect the phase efficiency. We have a lot of the factor. The most one is the viscosity of liquid. But the viscosity is also the volatility. It's high viscosity, the volatility is low. And the flow is also low. That's right, the flow is also low. Usually the plate efficiency is 90% to 30%. 90% to 30%. Decrease with increasing value of feed viscosity. That's right, it's very, very high effect, the viscosity. If high viscosity, the flow is very low. That's right, the flow is very low. Yeah, this is the correlation between the overall efficiency and the viscosity and volatility. Sorry, the volatility. is it the graph show you the term of the factor sign? Factor equal to mu square root low v. Low v mean the density of vapor and the tray efficiency based on Morphy efficiency. For each system, that's isobutane, butane, cyclohexane, heptane, something like this. It also depends on the viscosity. The viscosity is very, very high effect to the column of deterioration efficiency. I will talk to you for this case later. And the column that I talked to you, we have two kinds of column, place column and pack column. For the packed column, I will talk this more in the gap, this gap absorption, that's like the packed column. Okay, I will show you the column. Okay, this is I show you the example of the packed column in the deterioration. That's why we have some place column and packed column. That's why for the packed column, we have some material inside. There's material inside, and also we have the hole inside the column. The liquid and vapor can flow upward and downward. And also we have some contact area of the solid. In this case, the contact is also occur at the surface of the solid. It's at the surface of solid. I show you more. This is a kind of pack. In the laboratory, you can study the packed column for absorption and the place column for the deterioration. That's right. It's maybe a lot design of the packed column. Like this a design of the packed column. We talk in detail for the absorption later. Like this is the design of the column. Okay. This for the example of the column. We have a place column and packed column. In the last topic for the deterioration column, we call bad deterioration. And also you can find it in our laboratory. For the bad deterioration, we have no reboiler. That's right. We have no reboiler. We have only the feed at the bottom. Okay, we boil the feed and then we have some vapor evaporate and go to the condenser. That's right, go to the condenser. And also the product is spread out and some product is recycle or refuck. Something we call is the bad deterioration column. We have no the bottom. That's right. We have only the feed. Right. For this case, you all study in laboratory. Like this example of the bad. That's right. We have the feed to the heat exchanger, and also we heat by steam. And then the feed, it increase in temperature until reach the boiling point of the light product. And then go to the deterioration or condensate, that's like the liquid as the product. And also we can refuck some parts of the liquid to the column again. Okay, we talk for on Wednesday, some time for this case. Okay, minute. For this, we talk about the deterioration column. That's right. We talk about general. That's right. The general equipment. We have to kind of the column with the paste column and pack column. In this lecture and the previous lecture, we talk only the paste column. And also we talk in detail for the pack column in the absorption, because the most absorption use the pack column. But also we can use pack column in deterioration and paste column in absorption. That's right. And also we show you how to calculate the number of ideal pair and how to calculate the number of real pair. The number of real pair is depend on the efficiency. Okay, for next, and not next, Wednesday, I will talk to you again, example to calculate minimum number of pairs, that's right, the efficiency and the design of the column. And also we finally, we talk about the batch deterioration. The best situation on the next day. Okay, I will stop the class now. You have any question? I will continue for our example how to calculate in the next day. That's how to show you to calculate the efficiency, to show you to decide the pack column by calculation. And also finally, we talk about the best situation. And also we will continue on the absorption, that's right, absorption operation. Okay. Do you have any question? Are you online now? Okay. If you know question, then you stop the class. I'll see you on the next day. Yes, right.